It's the Miss South Africa 2021 pre-show, streaming exclusively on MissSA.live in proud association with the City of Cape Town, Sun International, Mnet and Mzansi Magic. Here's the host of the pre-show, Miss Universe 2018, Catriona Gray.
Welcome to the Miss South Africa 2021 pre-show. We will be going live in an hour's time, that's 5 p.m. Central African time, here in beautiful Cape Town, the host city of the Miss South Africa finale 2 years running. And you know what, guys? I had the distinct pleasure to visit some of Cape Town and surrounding areas' most beautiful and iconic spots since my arrival. And you know what? I've been having the time of my life. The beautiful city of Cape Town truly has a lot to offer, both to local and international visitors. The city's bustling energy,
naturally.
Yes.
Because I'm working with tourists every day.
I love it. Have you seen someone from the Philippines recently?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Are there a lot of Filipinos here?
Yes, there's quite a lot. There's quite a lot, but they're beautiful people.
Oh, thank you so much.
No
you.
Problem.
Thank
Please
you.
Come again. Enjoy your day.
I think I will. Okay. Here. And gorgeous year-round weather leaves everyone who visits her breathless. The surrounding areas also offer several world-class restaurants and wine farms.
I'm happy no one's sharing with me. Yum. So good.
And with tourism being the backbone of the city's economy, it is easy to see why it is one of the world's top tourist destinations. What a better way to cap off an amazing day. We have 10 gorgeous finalists this year who are as diverse as the people of South Africa. Let's remind you of who they are and what they are all about.
My name is Bianca Besaidnout. I am 22 years old and I come from the beautiful seaside town called Strand in the Western Cape. I am a dance instructor, business owner, as well as an honors student in media studies from UNISA. I am a great woman today because somewhere, sometime, great women of the past decided to show up for my future. I am ready to step forward for our youth as a leader who will stand up, speak up, and show up for the next generation. There is an urgent need for all of us to show up for our youth. As Miss South Africa 2021, I will show up.
My name is Catherine Groenewald and I'm 23 years old. I am proudly representing the vibrant city of Cape Town. As a millennial, I wear many hats. Not only do I study visual communications, I specialize in digital marketing and run my own online bakery. I am a great woman because I am resilient and I never give up. Perseverance is power to me. Our society doesn't always allow us to be seen, heard, and accepted. As your Miss South Africa 2021, I want to create a safe space where people can be free and without fear to be their authentic selves.
My name is Chanel Hartenberg. I am 24 years old. I come from the City of Gold, Johannesburg. I am a commercial pilot and work as a senior flight instructor and manager at a flight school. I am a great woman because I defy the odds and encourage others to do the same. As Miss South Africa 2021, I aim to highlight and come up with solutions for the issues facing our youth. Securing the prosperity of South Africa lies in ensuring that the needs of the South African youth are met. And that will be my mission.
Hi, South Africa. My name is Johnny Mulder. I'm 24 years old and I come from the beautiful small town Jeffreys Bay, but currently living in and representing the city of Cape Town in the Western Cape. I'm a full-time international model, but that has just made me realize how much I love South Africa, my home. I'm a great woman because I'm always my best self and I strive to be relatable. As Miss South Africa, I want to use my platform to raise awareness around youth unemployment and encourage people to follow their dreams regardless of their circumstances.
Good day, South Africa. My name is Kaylin Matthews, a 25-year-old that currently resides in the beautiful Gqeberha in the Eastern Cape. I'm a human movement science final year student at the Nelson Mandela University. I am a great woman because I am a reflection of being boldly authentic without an apology. As Miss South Africa 2021, I will dedicate my advocacy to speaking up about alcohol and substance abuse, dedicating time towards finding ways to not only combat it, but to further educate on the importance behind doing so.
Dumelang, South Africa. My name is Khotatso Ditebe, and I am 26 years old. I come from the Jacaranda city, Pretoria. I own a construction company, and I am currently an LLB student at UNISA. I am a great woman because I am resilient and I believe in second chances. Being Miss South Africa 2021, I would like to focus on bullying, mental health issues, and self-identity. I want to be the voice and give them hope for every young girl to know that anything is possible.
Hello, South Africa. I am 24-year-old Lalela Mswane, a proud Zulu girl from KwaSokhulu, KwaZulu-Natal. I have an LLB from the University of Pretoria and I'm currently a model and a dancer. I am a great woman because I love creating opportunities that seek to initiate positive and helpful change in my life and other people's lives too. Being Miss South Africa 2021 would allow me to highlight and seek solutions towards the abatement of unemployment in our country. My goal is to empower the youth at a school level with skills and knowledge that will equip them to secure their own economic future.
My name is Murakbe Masima. I'm 25 years old and I am from Midrand. I am a qualified medical doctor currently completing my internship. I am a great woman because I am a leader. Everything in my life has shaped me to be a woman that gives selflessly and advocates for the vulnerable. As Miss South Africa 2021, I would like to focus on the link between socioeconomic disadvantage and the direct effect it has on women's mental, physical, and reproductive health. It is imperative that young women are given the opportunities to shift the paradigm of our society.
My name is Tiffany Francis, and I am 22 years old. I come from the beautiful south side of Johannesburg, and I'm the proud owner of a youth and model development business called Tiffany K Models. I am a great woman because I do not let difficulty define me. The issue of unemployment in our country is one that hits home. Combining confidence and skills with natural given talent is key to creating opportunity. There has never been a better time to build our own doors, to empower, and to actively pursue change than right now. As Miss South Africa 2021, I strive to achieve this.
Molweni. I am Zemi Mabunzi. I am 26 years old from the true home of legends, Ekonce in the Eastern Cape. I am a final year BCom law student and I currently work for a teen empowerment organization called This Girl Wins.
I am a great woman because when I grow, society wins. I choose to live a life of intention and courage.
As Miss South Africa 2021, I want to focus on combating violence against women. I want to empower women with the protection of education so they can step into their full light.
Hello, South Africa. My name is Alela Mswane, one of your Miss South Africa 2021 Top 10 finalists. I invite you to join me as I journey through my hometown. Welcome to Richards Bay, KwaZulu-Natal. It is situated on a 30 square kilometer lagoon of the Mhlatuze River, which makes it one of the country's largest harbors. Richards Bay also has the deepest natural harbor on the African continent. Having been born in a coastal city, it is no surprise that I've always loved water and the sea. St. Lucia being a place my family and I have frequented since I was a baby and still continue to do so every chance we get. No matter where in the world I am, I will always return home, for Richards Bay is where the fondest memories are created.
Dumelang, South Africa. My name is Moradwe Masima. I am one of your top 10 finalists for Miss South Africa 2021. I am a proud city girl who grew up in Midrand, Gauteng, after my parents moved from Matatiele in the Eastern Cape to help further their studies. I was born in Charlotte Matlatya Hospital, which is the same hospital I now work at as a medical doctor. Growing up, I was an adventurous child and spent a lot of time in nature, climbing trees and swimming. Midrand was established in 1981 as the official halfway mark between Johannesburg and Pretoria.
Hello everyone, my name is Chanel Hotzenberg and I come from the beautiful city of gold, Johannesburg. And here you'll see me at one of my favorite spots. I grew up in the south of Johannesburg and went to Mondial Primary School. And then later I went to Parktown High School for girls. I enjoyed the arts and I did a lot of theater productions. What I enjoy most about Johannesburg is being able to spend time with my family.
Hello South Africa, my name is Catherine Krunewald and welcome to the city of Cape Town.
Growing up in Cape Town has definitely appealed to my sense of adventure. There's nothing better than being outside and seeing the beautiful city of Cape Town from all different angles. Whether that's paragliding or riding a bicycle or scooter down the promenade, I absolutely love anything that gets my adrenaline going.
Modeling is such a passion and a dream of mine, and I am so grateful for it every single day. But no matter how much I travel, my heart always craves home.
Hello, South Africa. My name is Tiffany Francis, and I'm one of your top 10 finalists for Miss South Africa 2021. And today I'm going to be taking you through my hometown and showing you where I grew up and what I call home.
I'm Bernadette. I'm Tiffany's mother. I'm so proud that Tiffany gets to experience this opportunity for Miss South Africa, and we are enjoying the journey that she has taken and seen all the amazing people she has met and all the great diverse opportunities she has gotten.
So here we are, the road to Miss South Africa 2021. The ladies are having their one-on-ones with the judges. I can tell you right now, whoever is going to walk away with the crown, she starts walking away with it right here. Shannon Ezra, what was the question for you today? The one question that where the answer shocked you, moved you the most, where you were like, okay, this is my take home.
One of the women said, confidence doesn't have to be loud. And we live in a world where
We're looking for loud confidence because we think that that's the assurity. Mm, mm. But there is something to tranquility and calm. Mm. I'm quite a loud, confident person. Mm. So it was wonderful to see the counterbalance of that.
Dr. Tamron Green. Now, you were a contestant, you were Miss South Africa, you were run up at Miss Universe, right? And now you are a judge.
Yes.
Okay. What quality do you think both judge and contestant need to have, you know, for this process to go beautifully?
As a judge, you need to understand that you have a certain idea about a woman, things you've read, things you've heard. But when she walks into that room, she can be completely the opposite. So be open to interpretation in both roles. The second thing is being authentic. Very importantly, as a contestant, you need to always be yourself. And the same goes for being a judge.
So there, one of the contestants is getting ready to go into, I would say, the final pre-judging process. It is here where it's her last chance to stamp that final, final, final approval from the judges. From here, she will only see them on pageant night. So, Pia, I'm interested to know, what question will you be asking the ladies where you know for a fact that their answer is going to give you great insight as to who they are?
When you're in a competition like this, your focus is just winning and getting the crown, but you often forget what your other plans are and what are the other things that you want to pursue. Now, being Miss South Africa or being Miss Universe is only a year's reign, but what I want to know is, do they have plans after that? What if they don't make it? Are they going to pursue their advocacy still? This gives me an idea if this is really a goal that's more than just personal gains.
The process of choosing a Miss South Africa doesn't happen over one night. A whole lot goes to making sure that finally on the night when we announce Miss South Africa 2021 is, we have to understand that every single possible question has been asked. Now, Professor Mamukheti, so Miss South Africa is a beauty pageant, right? So outside of the beauty and the height and the dresses and the makeup and the hair, right? What is that character trait that you're looking for?
They've got to be knowledgeable about their craft. We've got a pilot here. We've got people who say they're going to advance the course of education. We've got the woman who's in construction. How much do they know about their industry? And how much do they know about where the industry is going or what could affect the industry? Also, how does one handle a situation where you don't know? Because you know, when you're a Miss SA, people like, think you are everything.
You're an encyclopedia.
Exactly. Yeah. So what are you going to do when people ask you a question that you don't know? That for me matters.
This year, I'm looking for a woman who would understand the huge responsibility that comes with wearing a crown. I'm looking for a woman who wants and has a great and clear idea of what she wants to do with her life post her reign. Because ultimately, the crown is not about me, myself, and I.
It goes on. Next person.
You pay it forward. You use it as a legacy such that other young women can be able to be inspired, but continue to also bring others along.
Dineo Ranaka, what character trait do you feel weighs heavily on whether you decide, you know, to hand that crown over to that lady or not?
That would have to be, for me, and I'm sure you've heard this over and over again, authenticity. Mm. Many people's roles are filled. Fill your own.
Oh.
There's no better way to sell yourself and to charm people and win people over than being who you really are. It is you who gets chosen, not the character of somebody else that you're playing. If I can add one more, selflessness. You have to be fully selfless. Mm. So a person who's holistically well and so full within themselves that they're on overflow. Definitely those two. Yeah, you asked for one, I gave you two.
No, and this is why I'm saying to you, thank you, we are done here. I got everything and more out of you. The process is long, the process is intense, the process is grueling for both the judges and the contestants, but it is important because we're not just doing anything here. We are keeping legacy alive. We are finding Miss South Africa 2021.
This year, the Miss SA finale is broadcast from the Grand Arena at Sun International's Grand West Hotel and Casino in Cape Town. And this year, the production is going to be bigger than ever. And of course, I'm here with Stephanie Wheel, our CEO of Miss SA, and I'm so excited. What can the audience expect for the Miss SA 2021 finale?
Oh, Kat, what a wonderful opportunity to be sitting down and chatting to you. But the audience this year are gonna be in for a treat. I think it's gonna be one of the best shows that the country's seen, and hopefully internationally too. Obviously some incredible entertainment. And of course, we'll see who the next Miss South Africa is.
And I understand this is one of the first hybrid events to be carried on since the pandemic. You have both a live audience and an audience watching from home. What precautions have you and the organization made in regards to the COVID-19 pandemic?
I think we've been really cautious, being the first event of this nature to be live on television and in South Africa in the last 18 months. So, you know, we've kind of gone above and beyond. Everybody has to be vaccinated, and if not vaccinated, provide a negative PCR test on site. So we're trying to keep this as safe as possible.
And I know we have an amazing lineup of performers, of course, our top 10, our hosts and our judges. What can the viewers expect from the show tonight?
It is a spectacle. I think the fact that we have so many international queens in the room, I think everybody's more excited for the clothing and the outfits. So don't want to give much away because I'm so excited about it, but I can't wait for the viewers at home to tell us what they think.
Ooh, and tell us a little bit about the acts that we have tonight.
The acts on stage, I think we got one of the biggest South African, well, songs of the summer and DJs right now, Zake Spuntweedy. He's doing Swimwear with his brand new hit, Osama, which is gonna just, I think, be exceptional with amazing swimsuits and caftans by Tracy B. The evening gown is super special. I'm not gonna give that one away. And then we got a little bit of a special segment that's coming in that nobody's expecting. So we'll wait and see on that one. And of course, tonight we're also saying goodbye to my triplets, Shiru, Natasha, and Tato. So it's gonna be a really emotional one at the same time.
Stephanie Wheel, the CEO of Miss South Africa, thank you so much for sitting down with me and sharing a little bit what we can expect later tonight. And from one dynamic and strong woman to another, let's meet Michelle Openshaw, the choreographer of the Miss SA 2021 finale, who I had the pleasure of sitting with and getting to know a little earlier today. So aside from taking part in pageants, I'm also a huge pageant fan, and one of my favorite things about the final shows is the performances that happen on stage. And of course, someone very important to making the stage come alive, I'm here with Michelle Openshaw, the choreographer of Miss SA 2021. So I just learned that we have 12 fierce and amazing female dancers to perform tonight. So why was it so important to you to have an all-female dancing group?
For something like this, I really wanted to show how strong females are. I wanted to show all the different sides to them. So we have different performances, and I wanted each performance to be different. And I wanted to show that females can be soft and sultry, but then at the same time also strong and fierce and powerful. And it's unexpected to see a group of female dancers dancing that strong and that powerfully. So I wanted to show that because it's worth it.
That's amazing. I think it really speaks a lot to the values of what Miss SA stands for. And I also understand this is your first time choreographing a pageant. What has the experience been like?
I've absolutely loved it. I love choreographing for live stage, but now it's also for camera. And again, it's got so many different elements, the dancers, the performers, the artists, and then the finalists, of course. It's exquisite. It's a dream come true.
I can't wait to see the performances tonight. I think it's going to be amazing. And our audience and viewers are definitely in for such a treat. Thank you so much for taking some time with me, and I can't wait to see the show.
Thank you.
Now, of course, a pageant is always a spectacle, but behind that spectacle, we have an amazing vision. So I'm very excited to be standing here with creative director having a chat, Verna Vessels. Oh, you'll have to let me in. What can we expect the top 10 to be wearing tonight?
Kat, it is incredibly exciting this year. I just wanted us to really focus on the woman. First and foremost, clothing should be an extension of their personalities and not the other way around. So we can expect bright colors, a lot of fun, a lot of embellishment. My opening scene is incredible. I started my outfits a week ago. I changed them. I don't know if I was just crazy or really ambitious, but Yeah, so we changed them. It's beautiful. It has an African aesthetic to it because I really, because of all this international attention on us, I really wanted people to see Africa, especially during the opening scene.
And I also understand that the swimsuit competition also has a significant meaning behind it. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Yeah, the swimsuits, I just wanted something, I wanted to transport people. I think through COVID, you know, we've all been so hungry and so wanting to just get out and travel the world. So I want to take people on a journey and take them far, far away to a beautiful tropical beach and let everybody just experience that. And I think that's the most important thing that I wanted to showcase from our swimwear, is to really let people feel like they are transported to a tropical paradise.
Oh, we can't wait for that visual escape, but please let me in on evening gown competition, one of my personal favorites. What can we expect to see the girls in their dazzling gowns?
So evening gown is really exciting. I cannot wait to show people the evening gown section. I think we are doing everything the way that we used to do it. Every girl will be represented in her evening gown. She got to sit down with a designer and they got to design her own dream gown in the color that she wanted and the silhouette that she wanted. So you really will get to see every girl's personality shine through on that stage. And I love that because for the whole evening, there's very much a creative around everything. But then for evening gown, it's who are you? What do you want to show the world? This is you and this is your moment. And then I might have a little trick up my sleeve for later on in the evening, but people will just have to tune in and see what that is.
Ooh, I can't wait!
Oh my gosh, I'm so excited.
Thank you so much, Verna, for allowing me to have a little bit of your time. I know you have to get back to rehearsals, but I really am so excited to see what we are all going to see later. But guys, we have a quick ad break coming up, but don't go anywhere. We have more exclusive footage and behind the scenes interviews right here on MissSA.live.
Miss South Africa 2021 will take home a package of prizes worth in excess of 4 million rand. The winner will receive 1 million rand in cash from the Miss South Africa organization, as well as the use of a fully furnished and serviced luxury two-bedroom apartment at spectacular Central Square Sandton, with fabulous interior decor by Versa and home essentials from Woolworths, as well as the use of a Mercedes-Benz C-Class sedan for the year of her reign, as well as products and services from Bacher & Co, Kai Dental and Prosthodontic Practice, Lajawi Hair, Motherkind, Muck Hair Care, Neda Beauty and Healing, Sparkle Cosmetics, Jellish, Morgan Taylor, Steve Madden, Strands of Love, Switch Playground SA, Sekunder Color Clinical Psychologist.
So I am here backstage. It's during one of our very last dress rehearsals and our top 10 are behind me getting ready, getting glammed up, getting their energy in the right place. Let's go and talk to a few of them and see where their headspace is at. Are they excited? Are they nervous? Let's go check out. Hi. Johnny, so wow, you must be a whirlwind of emotions. I'm so curious, what was your first thought when you woke up this morning?
I'm so proud of myself. Honestly, there's so many emotions. We've been working so hard for this. The Miss South Africa organization has been working so hard, and the results will show.
Have you been able to talk to your family today? Have they given you any like pieces of advice or any like positive mantras?
Oh, my mom is a typical mom where she sends all these little pictures, you know, with the motivational quotes.
Aww.
So I've received a few of those, and then we send it on the top 10 group with all the girls just to motivate each other. But actually it's been so busy. I like quickly called my mom this morning. I'm like, it's happening.
Aww.
And she's like, I will be watching you because she's going to be in the stage. So I'm
Aww.
So excited.
Oh, amazing. Wishing you all the best luck.
Thank you so much.
And sending all of your love to mom and the family. Thanks for all the motivational quotes, mom. We love you. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Hello, hello. I don't mean to interrupt your beautifying session.
No worries.
How are you feeling, Marat?
I am feeling
very excited and emotional because, you know, I've waited for this moment all my life.
So I understand that you girls were given the opportunity to collaborate with local designers and actually contribute to the gown design. So what did that mean to you to be able to creatively contribute in that way?
Honestly, it meant everything to me because, as I said, I've always imagined myself on that stage and my vision honestly just came to life. I'm a very, very vibrant person and I think that I love a good mix of sexy and classy, and that's what my dress is really going to exude. So I think that people will be very excited to see what my dress looks like.
I'm excited to see how you will be blossoming with your energy on stage because I know how a dress can make a woman feel.
Absolutely.
But I also would love to know, is there any symbolism or does it mean anything special to you in particular?
So, I mean, the dress itself is actually derived from one of our childhood pictures. And so that's what makes it so special, is that you're looking at yourself as a five-year-old and really realizing just how you've become the woman that you are today. And I think that that's what that dress symbolizes for me, that I'm stepping into my power. I'm stepping into the Moratwe that I've always seen myself to be.
I love that. I love that you're referencing the growth and development you've had into this blossoming young woman. And so I'm really curious, if you could go back to, say, your 15-year-old self, as you are now sitting in the final dress rehearsal, Miss SA, what advice or what would you tell her?
I would tell her to stay calm. I would tell her to be true to herself, and that everything that makes her different and makes her feel like she doesn't fit in is exactly what will catapult her to be the person that she is today. That's what I would tell her.
I'm wishing you all the best luck. Shine out there, and I will let you get back to your makeup.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Hi, girl.
Hello.
I want us to come in. Come into our little, like we're having a dance off.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
No, because I'm a terrible dancer.
How are you guys feeling? What's the energy like?
We are so excited.
And I would love to know, is there a piece of advice, maybe from a family friend or a peer or maybe a fellow contestant that you guys are repeating to yourselves at these final days of the competition?
I think it's just to stay present, like just to soak up the moment to find ourselves in, because it's so much excitement that we forget sometimes.
Yeah.
But yeah, like these last few weeks, we've really been like, we've cried like 70 times in one day.
And that actually makes me think of a quote that my mother told me before coming here. She said, live to express, not to embrace, and work for applause, not for applause. And I think those are words that all of us can live by.
I totally resonate with that. And I mean, it's the essence of what Miss SA is all about.
Yeah, completely.
Absolutely.
And you know what? You guys are making a difference to so many young girls or young boys who maybe want to see themselves up on a stage one day, standing for something. So I'm so proud of each and every one of you. And I'm wishing you all the best luck. This is the last dress rehearsal. Get into that zone.
Ready?
That space where you feel the most powerful, the most confident, and just slay it on stage.
Thank you.
Hello, Kagatsu. Now you're a very familiar face to me. I love your story. What you stand for is incredible. And I just want to know, where's your heart at right now?
On the stage. I just want to get on stage right now. Mm-hmm. Just want to be on stage.
Yeah.
Do what I have to do. Enjoy. Yeah.
I'm very curious to know, has there ever been someone, a young girl or young boy, who has reached out to you either through social media or through a message that has really impacted you?
What I like most is young girls or young boys actually reaching out to me and saying, what happened? And I normally used to lie and say, oh, but you know, I got burned, so don't play with hot water. It's funny now, I'm just like, that's a birthmark. And they're like, what is a birthmark? So I educate them, actually, this is what's a birthmark. And I'm asking, where do you have one? Where's yours? And they're like, no, I'll get back to you. I need to go ask my mom. So it's, yeah, I do get a lot of people reaching out to me.
I love that you open up the conversation to help educate someone, because just as you said, there may be a young girl or a boy out there feeling like maybe they don't fit in, but here you are, a powerful woman embracing her uniqueness and just standing out so strong on stage. Thank you so much for your time. I'm wishing you all the best energy, all the presence of mind. You're gonna go out there and be amazing. Thank you for all that you stand for, and all the best luck to you.
Good luck.
The clock is ticking down to the live event, and guys, the excitement is real. The Grand Arena at Grand West has been buzzing with preparations and activity. So earlier today, I checked in with some of the other crew members working on tonight's live broadcast. I'm here in the outside broadcast van, where tonight's show will be streamed on MissSA.live, as well as Mnet Channel 101 and Mzan Seat Magic on DSTV. And of course with me, I have the technical director of the show, Nadia White. So Nadia, you've been in broadcasting for quite a while now, and I would love to know, what about it gets your heart racing?
You know, it's that adrenaline of that you never know what's gonna happen next. You can plan and plan and plan, and you can rehearse something to the 10th degree. But with a live broadcast, it's always that thing of that somewhere something's going to go exceptionally well, and somewhere something's going to go wrong. And it's how good you recover from that that's going to make it an exceptional show or not.
And as someone who's been in the front end of it, I've always been curious what happens behind the scenes. So can you let us in on what really goes into mounting a show like Miss SA?
A show like this, you need a lot of resources. We're using 13 cameras for the show. A massive crew of, I think technically wise, we're sitting at about 40 to 50 people just from our side. That excludes all the backstage people, all the choreographers, dancers. It's a massive undertaking. And you know, I think what really makes a great show is the team you put together. You need people that are passionate about what they do. And when you have that, it translates on the screen.
Well, thank you for taking the time to sit down with me and let me and our viewers know a little bit really what goes on behind the scenes. I won't take up too much of your time, but good luck with the show. I can't wait to see it.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
Right, it is almost time for tonight's action to start. The finalists are getting ready backstage, and we, along with myself, are brimming with excitement, and our guests are arriving on the red carpet. To see the arrivals of our studio audience, join us on the Instagram Live right now. Well, it's time for me to take my station. Good luck to all 10 finalists. Tonight we will be celebrating all women around the world. And remember, face your power, embrace your future. I'm Catriona Gray. See you shortly where all the action unfolds.